Hi, I'm Revanth. This is part 9 of a web services video series. In this session, we will learn method overloading in web service. Important synopsis we will discuss in this video are: what is method overloading? How to do method overloading in web service? Define the web method attribute with message name property. So let's begin the tutorial. If you haven't watched the previous videos, part 6, part 7, part 8 of this video series, I recommend to watch before proceeding this video. What is method overloading? Overloading means we will declare methods with the same name but different signatures. This overloading also called as compile time polymorphism or early binding. Method overloading or compile time polymorphism means same method names with different signatures. Signature in the sense different parameters. So in order to use method overloading in web service, we have to declare one of the method with web method attribute with message property. Let's we look in action how to create a method overloading in web service. Let's flip to Visual Studio. Click on File, New, Website. Select a template as Visual C Sharp. Framework has .NET Framework 4.5. Select ASP.NET Empty Website. Rename the project as Click on OK button. Once the project is created, right click on the project, click on add new item, rename the project as method overloading and the extension is .asmx. Click on add button. That will create the service. Now let's create one method. Public string get full name and the input parameters are string first name, string last name. When we call this method, it should return first name and last name. Return hello. First name comma last name. Let's copy this and paste it here. Let's build the solution. Look at this. It is saying type method overloading already defines a method called get full name with the same parameter types. So let's give different parameters now. let's give string has middle name. Now let's try to build the solution. So look at the status bar. It is saying rebuild has succeeded. Let's declare both of these methods with web method attribute. Let's build the solution, run the project, click on OK button. Look at this, it is throws server error / application. Both system.string get full name. This is a method we have created which takes three input parameters. First name, middle name and last name, and the two input parameters first name and the last name uses the message name get full name. So it is prompting to use message name property of the web method to be decorated to specify unique message name for the methods. Let's we declare the property for the web method attribute. Let's stop debugging. Message name equal to get first name, last name. Let's build the solution, run the project. So it throws one more error. It's a different type of error. Like a service method overloading does not conform to WS basic profile, has a basic profile. Let's make it as none. Let's run the project once again. Now look at this, get full name, message name equal to get first name, last name, and this is one more method which has three input parameters. Let's click on get full name, which takes first name and the last name. Let's give that has .NET Revant. Click on invoke button. So it gives the result as hello.net Revant. Let's close this. Now open get full name, which takes three input parameters, first name, middle name and last name. Let's give first name has .NET, middle name has web service, last name has Revant. Click on invoke button. It gives the result as hello.NET web service Revant. So it is working as expected. So in order to use method overloading in web service, it is mandatory to use web method attribute with the message name property. In next upcoming video, we will discuss how to use authentication in web service. Thanks for watching. For references and resources, visit these links and subscribe to my YouTube channel for email alerts. Thank you.